Good afternoon, students. Now the next is the question number 4 of the worksheet 2.4. If two zeros of the polynomial x raised to power 4 minus 6x cube minus 26x square plus 138x minus 35 are 2 plus minus root 3, find other zeros. So you have already discussed this question, which is in worksheet 2.3. So, now see the method. Two zeros are 2 plus minus root 3. It means 2 plus root 3. One zero is 2 plus root 3 and other zero is this negative sign 2 minus root 3. Two zeros can be written as alpha and beta. So, to find the quadratic polynomial, we have to use the this formula x square minus sx plus p. S is the sum. And p is the product of two zeros, x square minus sum is alpha plus beta and product is alpha into beta. This product is alpha beta. So, x square minus alpha is 2 plus root 3 plus beta is 2 minus root 3 and this x plus product is 2 plus root 3 into 2 minus root 3. We get x square minus root 3. Root 3 is cancelled out. We get 2 plus 2 is 4x plus 2 plus root 3 and 2 minus root 3. Their product is the identity formula a plus b into a minus b. We get a square minus b square. This is a and this is b. So a plus b and a minus b. A plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. So we get 2 square, that is 4, and this is 2 square minus root 3 whole square. We get 4 minus 3 is 1. So the quadratic polynomial is x square minus 4x plus 1. First of all, we have to find the quadratic polynomial by this method x square minus sx plus p. We have to find the sum of the two zeros and the product of two zeros and substitute the values of sum and product in this formula x square minus sx plus p. We get the quadratic polynomial. Now, what is the next step? You have to divide the quadratic. This polynomial is given. X raised to power 4 minus 6x cube minus 26x square plus 138x minus 35. Here the degree of the polynomial is 4. So it has this polynomial has 4 zeros. So 2 zeros are already given. We have to find the another 2 zeros. And by the 2 zeros which is given, we have already found this quadratic polynomial. Now this quadratic polynomial becomes the divisor. And the polynomial which is given, that is the dividend. We have to divide the dividend by the divisor by long division method. So x square, we have to make it x raised to power 4. We have to multiply x square by this x square. We get x raised to power 4 minus 4x into x square is minus 4x cube plus 1 into x square is x square. Now we have to subtract the second equation from the first equation. So all the signs are changed. This is for plus sign. So here is minus. Minus becomes plus. Plus become minus. So we get minus 2x cube minus 27x square plus 138x minus 35. So we have to multiply this x square by minus 2x. So we get minus 2x cube plus 8x square minus 2x. So we get here minus 27 minus 8 is minus 35x square plus 140x minus 35. Again we have to multiply this x square by minus 35. We get minus 35x square plus 140x minus 35. So the remainder becomes 0. This remainder always becomes 0 because 2 zeros that is given are 2 plus minus root 3. two zeros are given, and by these two zeros we have find this quadratic polynomial, and when we divide this polynomial by this quadratic polynomial, the remainder always becomes zero because it is the factor of the polynomial. Now by the Euclidean division algorithm, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, and remainder is zero. So by this formula, x square minus 2x minus 35 is quotient, and x square minus 4x plus 1, that is the dividend. And by this dividend, we have already this dividend is find out this divisor. This is divisor, and divisor we have already find by the two zeros that is given in the sum. So this is a quotient x square minus 2x minus 35, and we have to find the another two zeros by splitting the middle term. We have to find the factors of minus 35. So their product is minus 35, and we have to take the factors of minus 35 so that their sum becomes minus 2. So the factors are minus 7 and plus 5. After splitting the middle term, we get x square minus 7x plus 5x minus 35. From first two terms, x is common, we get x minus 7. From last two terms, 5 is common, x minus 7 here. From these two terms, x minus 7 is common, and we get x plus 5. So to find the zeros of the polynomial, as you know, x minus 7 is equal to 0 or x plus 5 is equal to 0, we get x is equal to 7 and x is equal to minus 5. So two zeros are 7 and minus 5, and for this polynomial, here the degree is 4, so we have to find the 4 zeros. These two, there are two zeros we have find out, that is 7 and minus 5, and two another zeros that is given in the sum, 2 plus minus plus root 3 and 2 minus root 3, and other two zeros are 7 and minus 5. Here are the four zeros are there for this polynomial. Is it clear? Now the next sum is question number 5. If the polynomial x raised to power 4 minus 6x cube plus 16x square minus 25x plus 10 is divided by the another polynomial x square minus 2x plus k, the remainder comes out to be x plus a. Find the value of k and a. So we have to find this polynomial. We have to divide this polynomial by this polynomial, that is the quadratic polynomial, by the long division method. So, x raised to power 4 minus 6x cube plus 16x square minus 25x plus 10. We have to divide this polynomial by the quadratic polynomial x square minus 2x plus k by long division method. So, first of all, we have to multiply x square with the x square to get x raised to power 4. Now, this x square we have to multiply with the minus 2x and k. So, we get minus 2x cube plus kx square. First term is cancelled, and we get minus 4x cube. Here these two terms, 16 and k, we have to subtract k from this 16. So 16 mein se to k minus nahi ho sakta. So we have to take x square as common. So we get 16 and this minus k. Baki terms minus 2 25x plus 10. So now x square we have to multiply this x square by minus 4x, so to get minus 4x cube. Second term is minus 4x multiplied by minus 2x is plus 8x square. Third term is minus 4kx. First term is cancelled out. Second term is x square. 16 minus 8 is equal to 8, and minus k, 8 minus kx square plus 25, this from minus 25 we have to subtract 4k, so x is common, we get 4k. प्लस साइन है 4k का, तो 4k एंड 25 जो है वो माइनस का साइन है, तो 4k माइनस 25 एंड दिस प्लस 10. सो नाउ वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई दिस x स्क्वायर बाय 8 माइनस k, वी गेट 8 माइनस k x स्क्वायर. Second term is 8 minus k multiply with minus 2x, we get minus 2, 8 minus k जैसे है इसको वैसे ही लिख देना है, 8 minus k x plus k into 8 minus k, we get first term जो है वो cancel हो जाएगी, second term में x common निकाल लेना आपने, first term देखें 4k minus 25, ये देखिए ये जो minus का sign है ये plus हो रहा है, तो ये बन जाएगा आपका plus 16, ये minus 2 और minus k आ जाएगा आपका plus 2k, और जब इसको subtract करेंगे तो आ जाएगा minus 2k, दोनों के ही sign change करने आप, plus 10 minus 8k, 8k plus की term है तो ये minus की बन रही है, k into minus k is minus k square, तो sign change करके आ जाएगा आपका plus k square, ठीक है, अब ये हमारा यहाँ पे x आ गया वेरिएबल, और यहाँ पे डिवाइजर की जो डिग्री है दैट इज इक्वल टू 2, और रिमाइंडर की डिग्री जो है दैट इज इक्वल टू 1, सो रिमाइंडर की डिग्री जो है लेस है डिवाइजर की डिग्री से, तो यहीं पे डिवाइड करना छोड़ देना आपने। अब इसके आगे का क्वेश्चन है द जब भी पॉलिनोमियल को डिवाइड करेंगे द रिमाइंडर कम्स आउट टू बी x प्लस ए, तो रिमाइंडर जो है वो x प्लस ए के इक्वल आएगा, तो हमारा रिमाइंडर है 4k माइनस 25 प्लस 16x माइनस 2k इज ऑल्सो देयर x प्लस 10 माइनस 8k प्लस k स्क्वेयर, सो इस टर्म को हमने x प्लस ए के इक्वल जो है वो इक्वेट कर देना है, क्योंकि ये रिमाइंडर आपको क्वेश्चन में दे रखा है और ये रिमाइंडर हमारा डिवाइड करके आया है। अब ये देखिए x वेरिएबल को बीच में इक्वल का साइन है, तो x वेरिएबल को x से कंपेयर करना है, a के साथ कोई वेरिएबल नहीं है तो इट मीन्स ये कॉन्स्टेंट है, कॉन्स्टेंट को कॉन्स्टेंट के इक्वल हमने कंपेयर करना है, सो वी गेट 4k माइनस 25 प्लस 16 माइनस 2k, x लिखना है लिख सकते हैं, नहीं तो कोफिशियंट को इक्वेट कर सकते हैं, x इज इक्वल टू x, x से x कैंसिल हो गया, सो वी गेट हियर 4k माइनस 2k इज 2k, माइनस 25 प्लस 16 इज माइनस 9 दैट इज इक्वल टू 1, 2k इज इक्वल टू 10 एंड k इज इक्वल टू 5। अब ये जो कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म है इसको भी इक्वेट करेंगे, 10 माइनस 8k प्लस k स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू a, कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म यहाँ पे a है, वी गेट 10 माइनस k की वैल्यू हमने निकाल रखी है 5, तो यहाँ पे k की वैल्यू सब्सटीट्यूट कर देंगे, 10 माइनस 8 5 जा 40 प्लस 5 5 जा 25 इज इक्वल टू a, वी गेट हियर 10 प्लस 25 इज 35 माइनस 40 इज इक्वल टू a, तो a की वैल्यू आ जाएगी माइनस 5, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यूज ऑफ k एंड a, तो k इज 5 एंड a इज इक्वल टू माइनस 5, इज इट क्लियर, इसको अच्छी तरह से डिवाइड कर लेना है, जो भी टर्म्स k या किसी भी कांस्टेंट टर्म में है तो उसको आपने कॉमन निकाल के सॉल्व करना है, डायरेक्ट इससे माइनस नहीं हो सकता, तो कॉमन निकाल लेना है और उसके बाद सॉल्व करना है, और ये वर्कशीट और ये चैप्टर ही आपका अब खत्म हो गया है, तो इसके बाद हम थर्ड चैप्टर स्टार्ट करेंगे, और ये पॉलिनोमियल्स में आपने इसको अच्छी तरह से प्रैक्टिस कर लेना है और इसके एग्जाम्पल भी सभी कर लेने हैं और इसको फेयर नोटबुक में कर लेनी है पूरी जितना भी चैप्टर है, ठीक है, थैंक यू।